this feeling that we are seeing get reported is a feeling that has been longstanding within the community. It's a fog of terror, quite honestly, of when people walk out the door, they don't know if they're going to get attacked and from where they're going to get attacked, right? If you hear these stories, they're in grocery stores, there are people walking on the street, there are people living their daily lives. And it's so important to understand that stories are empathy machines, right? And so what Helen was saying earlier about the need for our stories to be told in a responsible manner and for us to be seen as humans is really just a call for people to see our full humanity, for people to understand and recognize our dignity, right? Because silence is violence. In order for us to be treated as human, people need to speak us into the consciousness of this country. And we are seeing in the past several weeks that people are starting to wake up and people are starting to do that.
Could I add something to that,
please,
too? I think what Amanda is describing is a community that has gone underground, you know, throughout this pandemic and with the fears that you both describe. And what that's meant, we can see visibly that people are not going to their doctors, they're not getting meds, they're not getting tested, they're afraid to get vaccines. This is in the middle of a pandemic. And when we see reports that over and over again talk about the medical situation with this pandemic, they never mention Asian Americans. You know, the impact, the mortality, the morbidity. And why is that? Is it because they assume that everything is fine, which is what will fill in that void because there's a lack of that? They don't mention the fact that one out of every three nurses who have died in this pandemic is Filipina, Asian American. And so there's a void there. And the community, because of that void also, is further going underground and wondering, well, how, you know, what is it? We're not getting sick. And actually the health centers on the ground are showing that actually that there is a very high rate and exacerbated by the fact that people are afraid to even go to their doctors. And so so this is a terrible situation of a community that's been driven underground by fear of real attacks that are happening.